We want to solve the equation sine 2x times cosine 7x minus cosine 2x times sine 7x equals negative 0.5 or negative 1/2. We want to find the two smallest positive solutions and round to four decimal places. So for the first step, we want to simplify the left side of this equation using a sum and difference identity. So looking at the sum and difference identities below, since we have sine times cosine minus cosine times sine, we'll be using this sum and difference identity here for sine. So notice that A would be equal to 2x, and B would be equal to 7x. And also notice we have a difference here. So we're using the subtraction sign here, so we'll use the subtraction sign here on the left, which means the left side simplifies nicely to sine of A minus B, which would be 2x minus 7x, equals, I'll write this as negative 1/2. Well, 2x minus 7x is negative 5x, so we have sine negative 5x equals negative 1/2. But let's also perform a substitution using a negative angle identity. Sine negative theta equals negative sine theta, therefore we can write this as negative sine 5x equals negative 1/2. And now if we divide both sides by negative 1, we would have sine 5x equals positive 1/2. Now our goal here is to find the two smallest positive solutions for x such that sine 5x equals 1/2. But to help us do this, let's perform a substitution. Let's let 5x equal theta, so we can think of solving the equation sine theta equals 1/2. But we do have to keep in mind that we are solving this for x, so if 5x equals theta, if we divide both sides of the equation by 5 here, we can say x equals theta divided by 5, or if we want, 1/5 times theta. So now let's go to the unit circle, determine the two smallest positive solutions for theta, and then we'll come back and solve for x by multiplying theta by 1/5. So looking at the unit circle, remember sine theta equals y. Notice that sine theta is equal to 1/2 here, when theta equals pi divided by 6, and sine theta is also 1/2 here, when theta equals 5 pi divided by 6. So let's say theta sub 1 equals pi divided by 6, and theta sub 2 equals 5 pi divided by 6. But again, our goal here is to solve for x, not theta. So again, if x equals theta divided by 5, or 1/5 theta, then x sub 1 would be equal to 1/5 times pi divided by 6, which would be pi divided by 30. And x sub 2 would be equal to 1/5 times theta sub 2, which is 5 pi divided by 6. And this simplifies, so we have pi divided by 6. So these would be the two smallest exact positive solutions, but we are asked to round to four decimal places, so let's go ahead and do that as well. First we have pi divided by 30, which would be approximately 0.1047. And pi divided by 6 would be approximately 0.5236. I hope you found this helpful.